I mean, I was pretty much interested from the beginning. I talked to Scott briefly about the script, and he said that he had written the part with me in mind. And you know, I grew up in Texas watching Lonesome Dove on repeat, and so I mean, it wouldn't take much to get me to do a Western. And then you know, you look at the players involved, and yeah, I love working with Scott, so it was kind of an easy decision. I play Rudy Kidder, and he's fresh out of West Point, you know, which Blocker has a line that, you know, you don't see many West Point types in New Mexico. And so he's very well learned, you know, he's book smart, you know, sort of very prepared in that way, but has seen no real action. So he's sort of picked up by Blocker because, you know, he's about as qualified as you can get. The movie, in a nutshell, is sort of about Captain Blocker, who's a seasoned veteran. He's, you know, been fighting practically all of his life in the Civil War, and you know, well distinguished, and you know, is sort of notoriously sort of brutal and good at his job of, you know, killing and fighting the natives. And he's given this task, mission, to transport this aging, dying chief back to his homeland, kind of as a political ploy. And then we're off to Montana, pretty much. I would say that this Western is different than a lot of Westerns that I've seen. One of the things that I liked about it was that it does give you a perspective of kind of both sides, and there aren't really, you know, we don't paint the cavalry in a way as, you know, they're just heroes, and you know, I think it's a pretty honest depiction of the state of, you know, the United States during this time. I've loved Christian's work for a very long time, so I was really excited to get the chance to work with them. And I mean, you know, I think you always have some preconceived notion or, you know, what someone will be like, but he's really, you know, he's able to sort of turn it on really quickly. And in between scenes, he's really personal, really nice guy. And then as soon as you start rolling, you know, you become a little more intimidated. And yeah, he's just got a really strong presence that works, you know, really well for Blocker. Well, that guy, Scott Cooper, right? Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, he was approached by, I forget the original writer's name, but it's a 30-year-old script, I think. And the writer's wife, I think, approached him after having seen some of his films and said, "You're the guy to finish the script and do it." And yeah, I would work with Scott Cooper anytime. He really hires well and casts well and really gives his actors a lot of room and freedom to bring as much as they want.
Hi there, I hope you liked the video. Now, I have to be quick on this one as I'm trying to set a record. Did you know the shortest performance to win an Oscar for Best Supporting Actor was Anthony Quinn's 8 minute Tour de Force as Gauguin in the 1956 movie Lust for Life? Meanwhile, the shortest performance to win an Oscar for Best Supporting Actress was Beatrice Straight's 5 minutes and 40 seconds performance in the 1976 film Network. Yes! Well, looks like a bit both of them. So if anyone from the Academy is watching, you know where to find me. Oh, by the way, my name is Valeria. Now, remember, we publish new videos every day, so be sure to subscribe for more great content. See ya!